Hello and welcome to this video, which is about event volume curves. Now, hopefully you already know that on an audio part, if you hover over it, you have some handles which appear. So we've got the white handle at the top in this case, which allows you to control the overall volume. So I'm just clicking and dragging that. We've also got these triangular handles at the end and the beginning, which allow us to fade out and fade in. So you've got some reasonable control, and for most editing jobs, that may be all you need. But Cubase has something else, which isn't immediately apparent. And that is event volume curves. So these are volume curves which you can draw on an event, and then they are carried with the event wherever you put it. So if you duplicate it, those volume curves go with it. It's slightly different than automation, and while I appreciate it is possible for automation to get moved when you move a part or cut and paste it, etc., this is something which is always attached to that particular event. So if you go to the pencil tool and then move over a part, you can see the little waveform has appeared next to the pencil, and that's because it's about to draw in an event volume curve. So if I click once, it appears. You can see the volume of the whole part just changed because I just dragged that down by putting that there, and I can draw in another one just clicking somewhere else, and hopefully you can see that the volume that I've drawn in is being represented in the waveform. So if I take this point and drag it down, which you can do by clicking on an existing point, we can see it's going really quiet there. Let's just put one at the very beginning of the part. So it's going to be silent until here and then fade in. So this is something which this can't do. So this has to come from the beginning of the part, whereas if you need it to maybe, for some reason, you want to keep the beginning of that part, but you want it to fade in later, then you can do that with this. And you can see the little white handles appear and you can move those around. Now, if you create one that you don't want, if you hold down shift on the keyboard, you can see we've turned into the eraser, and then we're just going to click on this one here and off it goes. So they're pretty easy and straightforward to create. You don't get curves, etc., but you can go old school like you used to have to do back in the day before automation got those kind of nice things and curves, but you can draw these in, and you're probably not going to be doing such extreme stuff as this, but you know, maybe you are. Spend a bit of time drawing those in, and then you're going to get exactly the curve that you want. And what's important is that if we go back to the original handle here, we can turn this up and down, and it's combining the two. So if I take this fade away, you'll see the end of this changes. You can see this waveform here is changing as I get rid of the standard fade, as it were. So it's a useful way to either create more complex things or have automation, which definitely goes with a part when you move it around. Now, one thing which I think is useful here is you can see that this is still visible when I've clicked off this, and that's because I've changed a preference. So I'm just going to show you how to do that. On the Mac, you go to Cubase and Preferences. On Windows, it's under Edit. But under Event Display and Audio, you want to make sure that Show Event Volume Curves Always is ticked, because if it isn't, which is the default, when you're off a part, you can't see that there is an event volume curve in there, and that can be a little bit confusing. It appears when you hover over it, which actually I don't think it used to do at one point, but it's always been one of those things which appears when you click, and then once you're editing it, it appears in blue. But it might be nicer for it to have handles most of the time, but it doesn't. So the only way you can access those handles is with the draw tool. You can't do it with the arrow, so you know, don't spend fruitless time trying to do that, because you'll just move the part, etc. But yeah, making sure that that is turned on means that you get a much nicer experience as far as I'm concerned, because then you always know when you've put these on, because otherwise there can be, you know, 5 seconds of scratching your head is like, why the hell's that silent at the beginning? I thought that had something in it. So this is a good way to add more complex dynamic changes than the standard fades can do. And as ever, hope you found that useful, and we'll see you again soon for more Music Tech Tuition.